Hey, 40 years after the original, Mad Max is taking the world by storm all over again with a renewed interest in the cult classic. Craig Bennett caught up with one of the original stars.
Joanne, can you believe it has been 36 years since the original and best Mad Max movie came out?
No, I can't. It's incredible. It just seems like yesterday.
Joanne Samuel was cast alongside Mel Gibson in the original Mad Max in 1979, but scoring the role was something of a miracle.
Rosie Bailey got the role, but then they had that dreadful accident. They were going out early to location, and the sun was behind the bike. She was on the back of a bike, and a semi-trailer pulled out in front of them. Because the sun was behind them, the semi-trailer driver couldn't see them, you know? The light stopped him from seeing them.
My gosh, so Rosie Bailey, two broken legs.
Yeah, and Grant broke his leg as well. Alan Coleman called me into his office of the Young Doctors and said, "You're not in any of the episodes for the next couple of months." And I went, "Oh, why? What have I done? What's gone wrong?" He said, "No, you're out. No, don't want you in here anymore, not for the next 2 months." And I was just horrified, thinking I'd done something. He said, "No, you've got the part in Mad Max. Off you go. I'm darling, I've let you go. I've let you out of your contract. You can go into it." I went, "Oh, that is fantastic."
Mad Max held the Guinness record for the most profitable film for a few decades.
What we did on Mad Max 1 was just incredible. I think we recorded the highest decibel of sound. I think there was another record we broke where, you know, the shot where Steve the Goose is on his bike, Steve is, and he leaves the bike. I think it was the biggest space between the bike and the stuntman, really.
Evel Knievel, eat your heart
out. Eat your heart out, that's right. We did those things, no green screen, you know.
You did them for real,
you know. Grant Page, this country's best stuntman, he did that with a broken leg. When they were semi-trailer running over the bike, you know, he just ran over the bike and kept going.
Apart from the grand eye-popping stunts, what happened behind the scenes was nothing short of a little mad too.
I was sitting there at lunch and Grant and all the bikers came up, they grabbed me and pretended they were going to take me away, and then they took off my shoes and I thought, what are they doing? And everybody was just standing around going, what are they doing? Like, how far will these guys actually in fact go? They all started sucking my toes.
Really?
They were revolting because I used to wear these plastic little sandals on the set.
If people knew about this, I mean, remember the Fergie toes stuck sucking? For heaven's sake, you were long before that.
Long before Fergie.
You were, weren't you?
I thought, oh gosh, how could they suck those revolting toes? I've been working all day in these plastic sandals with dirt and dust.
Your response to this extraordinary...
I screamed at first because I actually really didn't know how far they were going to go or what was going to go on, because they actually really became those mad characters, you know? They were really, really playing it that way.
I'm going to die historic on the Fury Road.
The world has gone nuts for Mad Max all over again, and so everyone wants to know about Joanne Samuel, Jesse, Mel Gibson's wife. I mean, what's it like to be a cult figure?
I don't think about it that often, really, to tell you the truth. I don't feel like it, but a friend of mine did say it was that shot of me running down the road with the baby in my arms. It's an iconic shot for the Australian film industry. It made me think, that's great, that's fantastic. What an amazing honour.
You just take my word for it, get it?
Well, still to come on Studio 10, Joanne opens up about what Mel Gibson was really like. Stay right where you are. Stunning revelations coming up next. Time now for part two of Craig Bennett's interview with the original Mad Max star, Joanne Samuel, and she opens up about what Mel Gibson was really like. Take a look.
Crazy about you.
Mel Gibson was to become one of the hottest stars in the world. Did you see that in him back then?
He had it. You know, when he was on the screen, your eyes went to him. A lovely actor, classically trained actor. But he just had that look. You didn't think about it. I didn't think about it at the time. We were all in there together, you know? And you'd sort of think, oh, well, if one makes it, you know, we'll all make it, you know? But he did have that wonderful, wonderful presence on screen. that did set him apart, I think.
Was he a good kisser?
Yeah.
I'm so glad you're kissing and telling.
Yeah. No, he was.
And you two became great friends too, didn't you?
Yeah, we did. When he went to Hollywood and everything happened for him, I guess there was a long break of not much contact, because I think, you know, I can't imagine what it must be like to be Mel Gibson in Hollywood, you know? It must be incredible. I mean, it's great, but it would have its downsides.
Well, look at the firestorm, that terrible firestorm that broke out around him 5 years ago. That was not the Mel Gibson you knew, was it?
No, not at all. Not at all. No, he's always been a really nice, friendly, gentle person, lots of energy and great fun. We emailed a little bit to say that I'm there with him because we share the same faith, so I've always really believed that God's been with him. None of us are perfect. We all, you know, say things and do things that you might regret. You've got to cut him a bit of slack. He's a human being and we all, you know, blow it from time to time. We're not all Mel Gibson with people recording us and editing and putting things together to make us look bad, you know?
Years after Mad Max, Joanne found out she had bowel cancer, but longtime friend Mel Gibson was there to help.
He is so kind and so generous, and a lot of people don't know that because he doesn't spruik it. I think he thinks that charity doesn't boast. He offered that I go over there to get treatment, and he offered to be there and help. But I just think going through what I was going through, I needed family, I needed my friends around me, and I thanked him very much, but decided to stay here.
Are you sad your Jesse didn't continue in 2, 3 and maybe 4?
Yes, that would have been great.
Couldn't you have twisted George Miller's arm?
Yeah, we've got to do that.
Would you like her to come back as a ghost
or something? Absolutely, couldn't she? Oh, it's sort of a ghost as a grandma now.
Why not? Or couldn't she just come back as another character?
Yeah, absolutely. That would be great.
Because Mad Max 5 is now on the radar.
Oh, really?
Joanne, I think you need to be. Let's get a petition running.
You could tell me more about Mel in Hollywood and everything. I know. See, medical science has come a long way.
Oh, yeah, that's right. That's I mean, look what they did with Dolly the sheep.
That's right.
They could clone her, couldn't they?
Perfect.
There you are. You and Mel are back for Mad Max 5.
Thanks.
George Miller, we've figured it.
That's it.
Okay, we'll tell you where to send the check.
There you go. Jess, is it the latest one? Is setting up for another sequel? We could see another Mad Max anyway.
It was so good. I saw it the other night.
It's been so successful.
It's amazing.
Oh my goodness.
Yeah.
Edge of your seat. Yeah. And it's girl power too, which I love. Charlize Theron is just incredible in that lead role.
But apart from that, it's a really good film.
The stunts are, you know, they're going to change the way they make movies.
It is amazing, though. It is the most
visually incredible film
I've ever seen. I think George Miller has already said that they are going to make another two now because this one was so
Wouldn't you like to see Mel have a bit of a cameo in one?
Yes, that'd be amazing.
Do you think he can have a comeback?
I think there's room for him. You know, Hollywood loves a comeback story, and I think this is sort of the perfect vehicle for him.
Yeah. Maybe Mel could be driving home and Max pulls him over.
Breathalyzes him.
Oh.